Hello, puppet.
So science fiction is a genre that's popular with millions of people across the world, and that's because it transports us to a place that's just way more interesting than real life. And a big part of that are the characters and the storyline, of course, but an equally big part is the futuristic technology that's in the story. But a lot of people never stop to consider whether some of these technologies might actually exist, and believe it or not, more than a few of them actually do. So this week, I wanted to share with you some amazing sci-fi tech that isn't so fictional, so here they are, 10 sci-fi technologies that actually exist. Number one are smart contact lenses. As just one more step to what will probably end up as us being bionic, Google has developed a smart contact lens. The lenses, which will be available to consumers within the next 5 years, are a huge deal to diabetics who will no longer have to prick their fingers 5 to 10 times a day. These lenses measure your glucose levels simply by being on your eye. But the really cool thing about them are their potential. They've already developed the wearable computer Google Glass, so it's logical that it's just a matter of time before they're able to merge the two technologies. It's just kind of unfortunate that Google owns yet another piece of technology that could potentially track you. I mean, they already know what websites you go on. Yeah, I'm looking at you, the guy that goes on goatlovers.com. They know how you like to get freaky. Number two is modumetal. Modumetal is a new age metal that's as close as we've ever come to having adamantium, the indestructible supermetal found in Wolverine's skeleton. This nano-laminated alloy is lighter and stronger than steel and is virtually indestructible. It's a groundbreaking technology that's already begun to replace traditional metals and things like military armor, but has almost limitless other uses. It's believed that this metal will eventually be in cars, planes, buildings, bridges, and pretty much anywhere else that requires traditional steel. Number three is bioluminescent light. A company called Yonder Biology has created something that looks like it's straight out of the movie Avatar. The dino pet, as they call it, is a container shaped like a dinosaur that's full of bioluminescent algae. The algae absorb light energy during the day and glow with a brilliant neon light at night. What's interesting is these algae have always existed, specifically in the luminous lagoon in Jamaica, but these guys were brilliant enough to turn it into something that you can buy to make your house look really cool. See, this is great because it's a much safer entertainment alternative than those glow sticks, because I remember when I was a kid, I saw another kid bite into one like it was a pepperoni, and his mouth was glowing. Then he went to the hospital, but it was funny for the first while. Number four is optical camouflage.
Harry Potter fans, get ready for a major nerd boner.
Optical camouflage, better known as an invisibility cloak, doesn't rely on magic, but instead is a very real technology. The way that it works is by using augmented reality technology, it bends light around the subject wearing the material, making them appear virtually invisible to anyone looking at them. It doesn't make you completely invisible like in the movies, but instead gives you a highly translucent look. It's quite a complex process, and the real life application are still being tested, but everyone can agree this is really cool. Imagine being able to walk around like this.
Hello, I want to be your friend. Don't be afraid.
Number five is 3D printing. By now, most of us have heard of 3D printers, which are those printers that can print nearly any size or shape 3D object from a virtual model. But what you might not know is how far they've already come. On top of being able to print objects using plastic, glass, and metal, these machines are now capable of printing fully edible food like mashed potatoes and chocolate, and even living cells. There's even a company called Boots Industries that's developed a self-replicating 3D printer. Yeah, as in a machine that can create copies of itself. Self-replicating machines, yeah, that sounds like a good idea. It's not like the enslavement of mankind was foretold based on that very premise, except for every other sci-fi movie for the last 15 years, but you know, whatever. Yay, printable pizza! Number six are self-driving cars. Google's self-driving cars have been a reality for a while in California, however they still aren't available for commercial use, unlike in the United Arab Emirates where they've had self-driving cars in commercial use since 2010. The Zagato pod car is reminiscent of the robo-taxis from the 1990 movie Total Recall and services about 25,000 people a month. Developed by European company To Get There, these fully autonomous cars are part of a growing project to create a city that runs on clean and renewable energy sources. I really cannot wait until these replace regular cars because they're a lot safer than the way some of you drive. Kitty agrees. Number seven is a universal translator. Similar to the idea behind the TARDIS in Doctor Who and the universal translator from Star Trek, a real-life universal translator really does exist. The Sigmo voice translator is a little device that you simply speak into in one language and it repeats your sentence in another chosen language. It can translate your speech into more than 25 different languages and is so advanced that it can actually translate what you meant, not just what you said. And apparently it's quite accurate with its translation, which is fantastic because the last thing you want is to try to speak Mandarin in a Beijing restaurant when you really don't understand the language and you end up ordering cat or something, which I really don't think they'd appreciate unless they actually served cat.
in which case they'd bring it to you.
Number 8 is bionics. Remember Luke Skywalker's mechanical arm from Star Wars? Well, that technology now exists. Bionics is the term for the technology that merges biology and machinery. From a medical standpoint, it means the replacement or enhancement of organs or limbs by mechanical versions. In fact, just this year, an amputee named Dennis Sorensen was given a bionic arm that allowed him to feel the sensation of touch for the first time in 9 years. Now, the technology is still young, so the bionic hand itself is quite big and not aesthetically pleasing, but that doesn't matter. It's not like anyone's gonna go mouth off to him about it. He's got a metallic arm. He'll drop you like third period French. Number 9 is the password pill. If you hate entering passwords, then this is for you, if you aren't completely freaked out by it. Motorola developed an edible authentication vitamin pill that, once swallowed, turns you into a living, breathing human password capable of unlocking all your devices. The way that it works is that after swallowing it, the digestive liquids in your stomach activate the pill. Once activated, the pill starts emitting an 18-bit signal from your stomach that's strong enough to be detected by computers and smartphones, unlocking them. Interestingly, although Motorola has no immediate plans to release this to the public, it is FDA approved, so it could be at any time. Now, I know a lot of you are going to be against the idea of edible technology, but at least it's an oral pill and not a suppository. Always look for the silver lining, folks. And number 10, powered armor. Exoskeletons like those found in the movie Alien have been around for a while, but are used purely to enhance human endurance and strength, not to fly or shoot weaponry. Until now. Powered armor, also known as an exosuit, essentially makes the wearer a real-life Iron Man. As hinted by President Obama earlier this year, America is in fact building a real-life Iron Man suit, but further details are unknown as it's top secret. You know, I'd imagine that this suit, unlike the movie version, probably takes a long time to put on and take off. So a practical question would be, what happens when Iron Man has to go potty? Do the engineers build in like a little flap, or does Iron Man run the risk of pooping in a billion-dollar metal suit? Just curious. And that's all for this video, guys. I just wanted to take a minute to say thank you to all of you, because yesterday I hit 500,000 subscribers, which is a crazy accomplishment that I never thought that I would get to when I first started doing this, and yet here we are. So thank you so much. Your support means the world to me. And if you'd like to add me to Facebook and Twitter, the links to those will be in the description along with all my other social networking links. And other than that, I will see you guys back here next Saturday with a brand new video. Peace.
I see you made it to the outro screen. Welcome.
Hey guys, thanks for watching my new video. If you enjoyed it, please remember to click the big red subscribe button below. To subscribe to my channel, I release a new video every Saturday. And while you're at it, maybe click the like button and share this on Facebook. And that's about it. I'm gonna go outside and enjoy the beautiful sunshine, because spring is coming, baby. You can feel it. It's in the air. It's nice and sunny. So I hope you guys have a great weekend. I will see you next week. I don't know what that was.